Also nicknamed as the Olympos of Moldova, the Ceahlău Massif represents the most spectacular mountain unit in the center part of the Eastern Carpathians. Stream erosion resulted in multiple levels of relief. The central plateau, raised up to 1,800 meters, is about 6 kilometers long and 1 kilometer wide. It resembles suspended trough, culminating in two high summits of the Ceahlău Massif, Ocolaşul Mare in the southern part, reaching 1,907 meters, and pyramid-shaped Toaca in the northern part. This central plateau is bounded by 200 meters deep ravines with hardly accessible chimneys and cliffy walls, forming characteristic ledges marked by belts of coniferous trees that have managed to take roots there, Polița Cucrini being a case in point. They stretch over the level of hill ridges which extend from 800 to 1,300 meters. The Ceahlău Massif consists mainly of thick layer of conglomerates folded in strips oriented in north-south direction with alternating layers of sandstones and limestones. The most characteristic feature presents micro-relief created by fascinating rock formations, isolated cliffs, towers, and columns such as Ceahlău Mare, and especially Panaghia. The Ceahlău Massif hides one of the most impressive waterfalls in Romania, namely Cascada Duruitoarea. This monument of nature is about 25 meters tall, but the fall of water is divided into two tiers by a threshold. The height of the upper part is approximately 20 meters, while the lower part measures about 5 meters. There are wooden ladders enabling access through the exposed sections. The highest peak of the Ceahlău Massif, Ocolaşul Mare, has craggy west, south and east faces, which boast so-called coloana dorica, being in stark contrast to table-like grassy north face. Toaca summit has metal station on its top. The legend has it that harsh winter killed almost all ox breeders, while only a boy and a girl survived. They started building two towers, but another cold wave hit the mountains, resulting in freezing those two giants. Since then, the big tower is called Toaca, and the smaller one, situated half a kilometer north, is named Panaghia. Another legend has it that Panaghia was a beautiful girl hiding in the mountains. The sun fell in love with her and caused the night to be shorter. The god punished the sun to rise only in mist and clouds, and Panaghia wept due to missing her beloved son. The god listened to her prayers and she was turned into a rock while the sun was released from the captivity. The Ceahlău National Park was established in 1955. Nowadays, it covers an area of more than 8,000 hectares. The southern part of the plateau forms a strictly protected scientific reserve named Ocolaşul Mare, created in 1998. Another scientific reservation called Polița Cucrini was founded in 1941 in order to protect mighty large trees, more than 30 meters tall and 1 meter in diameter. Detunatele are actually two creeks named Cetățuia and Calugari. The legend has it that wealthy king buried his treasure under these stones. The devil searched for it, but without success. In his anger, he threw thunders and lightnings into the rocks, splitting them in two. Almost three-quarters of the territory of the Ceahlău National Park is covered by forests. The upper forest line of mixed woodland can be found at 1,300 meters, while the timberline of conifers with rare yew trees reach 1,700 meters. Dwarf bushes and juniper shrubs dominate the subalpine zone, while the alpine zone presents extraordinary botanic garden with more than 1,000 plant species, among them 62 being Carpathian endemic species. One of rare species of flora protected by law is Edelweiss. Typical wildlife representative is the chamois, introduced in 1970. Resemble two impressive tusks, and the legend has it that a shepherd called Miron liked them very much. He was singing at this place till the end of his days, and all the creatures, rocks, hills, and rivers stood still to listen to his wonderful songs. Over the last decades, the Ceahlău Massif has been very well equipped with accommodation facilities, especially in Dura Resort, providing home for an Orthodox monastery. Dokia Hut offers the most convenient option for hikers. It is situated in the center of the plateau on the crossroads of the most visited hiking trails. Its capacity is up to 100 people. There is a wooden church in the heart of these mountains with spring of water named Fontana Rece. Toaca refuge with meteo station isn't open to public. The only designated campsite in the Ceahlău Massif is located at Piatra Lată din Gedeon. Piatra Tiulu is 23 meters tall rock surrounded by the waters of Izvorul Munțelui Reservoir. The legend has it that an ogre stealing the girls from nearby villages takes them on the top of this crag and then he transforms them into stone pieces with strange shapes. The climate of the Ceahlău Massif is influenced by the altitude, structure and the orientation. The more common occurrence on sunny days on the eastern side of the mountains is due to the fans. Kushmandorul Bantului resemble an armed soldier with a cap. This spectacular needle has characteristic orange coloration due to iron admixtures in the conglomerates. The Izvorul Munțelui Reservoir with a length of 35 kilometers belong in one of the largest lakes in Romania. Piatra Ciobanului is a cluster of walls towering abruptly over the valley of Rupturi Creek. The legend has it that a young shepherd was outstanding storyteller, gathering all the animals around him to listen to his stories. When he died, the local people named his beloved place the Shepherd's Rock. Ocolaşul Mare presents extraordinary gallery of limestone and conglomerate cliffs, especially when seen from Poiana Maicilor. Turnul lui Butu boasts giant wall on its south face. Piatra Lacrimata resembles beeping human face. The Ceahlău Massif is considered to be the homeland of Dacian god Zamolxis. These mountains were mentioned by many writers because of their legends revolving around anthropomorphic rocks with strange shapes, contributing to the mysterious aura of this spectacular massif.